Greetings from Tallinn, Estonia, where I am currently attending the International Orient Music Festival 2015 edition. The Orient Music Festival is a leading musical event in the Baltic states where music and art lovers can enjoy performers from all over the world. Away from the festival, it's been a great time discovering the beautiful city of Tallinn and other parts of Estonia. Enchanting, beautiful, modern, but traditional are what I would use to describe Estonia as well as the people I have met here. It is said that women's status in a society shows the strength of that society. I have been very curious to find out how strong Estonia is by virtue of the status of women in this country. On the surface, Estonia is doing pretty good in terms of gender legislation. From my interviews with the people I have met, Estonian women have always been strong and have always had many rights. This morning, I had the honor of sharing coffee with a powerful Estonian woman. At the top of her career, Tiina Kangro is a celebrated journalist, a leading social activist, and the editor-in-chief of Linalet, a leading network of newspapers in Estonia.
Yes, I am a journalist already for more than 25 years. I have been working for half of my life in the national television company. And now for the last 10 years, I am editor-in-chief of a group of newspapers. The reason why people think I am powerful in a way is more tied to my voluntary work, which is one part of to be a journalist also. But you actually, to tell the truth, you cannot be just a journalist writing or sending out news and being content with it, because if you are a journalist, you really must think a bit more wide, and you should see what are the issues that can change the world, because journalism is also all the question of how to change the world. My issue basically for all these long years has been social policy and social situation of people. Estonia is a little country of only 1 million people, which has a quite difficult history, because we have had for 50 years the occupation of the Soviet Union here. And this means that very many people have been suppressed. We have lived under the totalitarian leadership of the Soviet Union, which changed the life so that people were suppressed. They didn't participate actively in the civil society. And now that we are again independent for 23 years, we have to learn again how to be active as citizens.
What has your experience been like working as a female journalist in Estonia?
Yes, that is a tricky question in a way, because from one side, we do not have gender issues here in Europe. Men and women are, according to the law, they are equal. And when you go to the streets, you can see that they really are equal. They are everywhere. And here in Estonia, as well as the whole of Europe, we do not have the issue that women should sit at home and take care of the household, and men are the ones who earn money and do more attractive things. We don't have that situation. But we have the issue of, so to say, the glass ceiling, which is a phenomenon very much talked about in Europe. To talk about Estonian women So what is specific for us is that very many women are single mothers. They have never got married or they are divorced and they have just sent away the man who has turned out to be not useful. Okay. And the women are working and they are taking care of the home and they have children. Usually the single mothers have one or two or sometimes even three children. But the problem is that according to the statistics in Estonia, we have one of the biggest pay gaps in the European Union and also in the OECD countries, which means that women work very hard, they work very long hours, they take care of children, but they earn something like nearly 30% less.
But as real as the glass ceiling is in journalism and other businesses in Europe, you are one woman that has broken through that glass ceiling. You are editor-in-chief of a very big network of newspapers. Mm-hmm. You own your own TV production firm and you're an activist. How did you break through?
Yes, actually, I must say that in journalism and in media, we have very many women in high positions. So we used to have a time a couple of years ago where most of the editor-in-chiefs of major news channels and newspapers were women. So I am not an exception in that way. But maybe I am a little bit of exception in the way that I am one of those women who really work very, very much. And as we were talking here before this interview, that I have the official work, which is editor-in-chief of a group of newspapers, which have one of the biggest circulations here in Estonia. And that's a great job, and that's very interesting, and takes very much time. But in addition to that, I have this, I am a kind of leader for the civil movement to fight for human rights, to fight for better social policy, to fight for the rights of disabled people, and to fight for the rights of carers. Because here in Estonia, we do not have very good social system like in the Nordic countries, like in the old European countries. We have a situation where people who really cannot work and earn, who have disabilities or who have a family member who is ill or needs assistance, those people are really in a very, very difficult situation, and we are fighting for them to get more courage to fight for themselves and to get better legislation which would help them to fight for themselves.